Hello everyone, this is Tracy Kelly coming from Homeschooling is My Superpower. You can find me over at www.homeschoolpower.com. Hello and how are you? I have been away for too long and I wanted to do a video on my preschool binder. Now if you follow me on Instagram, and if you don't, by the way, you can go to my YouTube page and in the corner you will find my Instagram icon. Please click on that and follow us. But on Instagram, I actually showed a picture of my preschool binder. And I wanted to show you how I put it together. I wanted to show you why I put certain grade levels in there and why it works so well for us. I also wanted to show you how I get the materials. And I want to show you how I did it for fairly cheap. That's always important. But first of all, before I begin showing my binder, I wanted to thank each and every one of you, not only for just following us, but for the comments that you leave, for the emails that I get. It just touches me to know that we are helping people and that it is making this journey easier for you, that I'm answering questions, that we're just giving a good look into homeschooling and using homeschooling as this, you know, as an educational option. I'm just blessed. Even though I was inactive on YouTube, I'm still getting subscribers, and it just means the world to me that you all come by, watch, and listen to what I have to say. So again, thank you so much from the bottom of my heart for following our little journey. Well, let's get started on our word notebook. So I will have a pre-K student this year along with a third grader and a middle school student who will be sixth grade. I cannot believe it. If you look back at our journey, you will see that I started when he was in pre-K. So this has been a journey. I can officially say that I have homeschooled a child all the way through elementary school. So I am feeling so blessed. And I'm so proud of him. He has overcome many challenges. If you follow us, you would know that health-wise. But more than that, I'm so proud of who he is as a person. I'm so proud of the way he learns. And I'm just proud. I'm a proud mom of all of my kids. But it just warms my heart to see him grow and to enter into this new phase of his life. And I'm just reminded to take every day and make every day special, because time just goes by so fast. So although I love homeschooling, I love the academics of it, never forget to cherish the family and the love that you have inside your home. I'm a firm believer that it's not about a building, it's not about the size of your home, it's about what you fill it with. And I plan to fill mine with laughter, with love, and just with memories. And I hope that when they come home, or when they speak about their homeschooling journey, that it'll be good things. It'll be good memories. It'll be good things to talk about. And that's what I focus on every day. So here is the preschool binder for Christian. He will be going to pre-K. He's 4 years old. He loves Caillou this year. So I had to add his friend to make the binder a little bit more exciting. I actually did this on Word. Found this online, clipped it to it, it's done. Inserted it into the little front flap. And this, by the way, is a 1.5 inch binder. You can use a binder whatever size you like. If you need one with more space, get it larger. If you don't need as much space, or it's easier for you to use the smaller ones, you know, do what works for you. And again, you don't have to do it exactly the way I do it, or I did it. I just want to give you an example of what I've done with preschool and why it works for us, and it may just give you some ideas. Okay, so inside of the flap I have an alphabet chart. Now this is something that you may want to do for circle time. You may want to go over alphabets or sounds. You also may want to do the numbers. And everything I do is colorful for a four-year-old, because that kind of keeps their attention. Also, I have shapes here to review, and you can be as creative as you want to do with your you know, with your charts. You can do games, you can just, you know, do it. It was so funny, like last week I totally just did a little quiz on his colors, And I just told him to, you know, I'm gonna speed this up. I'm gonna point to him as fast as I can, and you tell me as fast as you can what color it is. He thought that was the best thing ever, and at the same time, it was a review. So, like I said, you can be as creative as you want to be. You can add whatever you may want for your charts. You may not want to do just alphabets, or you may want to add in something different, maps, or you know, different things, continents, whatever, wherever your child is and what you want to teach, you can do that. Also, I have dividers here. So to make my binder, the first thing I purchased, of course, was the binder. Then I did the dividers. I also purchased these. Now these can be your best friend. If you don't know about them, I'm gonna tell you. Now, if you don't have a laminating machine, which is on my list, these will be great because not only can you use these for your binder to slide your papers in, but you also can use these for dry erase if you want to practice letters and then erase them away. Let them write on them. If you don't have little dry erase boards, you can use these. Also, you can use these to put your worksheets in. If you want to reproduce your worksheets, you can put these in, or recycle your worksheets. You can put these in and get them write on it, and then they can erase it and you can use the worksheet over again. So these are great, and you can get these from the dollar store. I think I got this one from Walmart, but they have these at the dollar store. And this is a 25 pack. This won't last me, so I'll be getting a bigger pack of these. But they're fairly cheap, and you can use them for so many different things. Okay, so I did that for my binder. I also had to have things to put in the binder. Where did I find all those worksheets and things? For one thing, I do have some things online. I've subscribed to education.com, which is one of my favorite websites. You can get free printables if you subscribe and you're a member. Now, they do have a free membership, but they limit your printables, how much you can print. That does not work for me with three kids. So what I did was I bought the $46 a month membership, and I can get unlimited printables. They also do unlimited workbook downloads, so you can print from those. They also give you lesson plans. They have online games and lessons for the kids to do in game form. So it is amazing. It's great for $46 for the entire year. So it's not $46 a month, it's $46 for the entire year, and it's unlimited. So I use that. I also had this that we've been working in all year, this year when he was three. So as you can see right here, let's see here. Okay, right here, Christian, he was working on his color blue. And we did not finish this worksheet. So what I did was I pulled some of this for a beginning of the year review in his binder. So I have that one, which was $4 for that one. I also have this one, which was one of my favorites that I got from Walmart. Now this one was $8 and some change. I can't remember the exact amount. And this was a really big book. You see this big workbook? It was big. But you can see where I got the majority of my resources from because I pulled a lot from this book. This is actually for grades, I mean for ages 3 through 5, so it would be preschool. And they go over things and they also progress up to the kindergarten year. So I really love this workbook, and it's colorful, and I love the fact that most of the pictures and the writing and numbers are large, which is great for little eyes. Okay, I also had this book from my daughter, who is now going to be a third grader. She did not do very much in this book. We worked in this a little bit, and I kind of was like, you know, we're done for the year. So I kept it, which I do most of my stuff. I'm trying to build a little homeschool library. I got a lot of little resources going on that I picked up from my time my son started all the way to now. So I have a little library getting started. But I pulled the kindergarten book, and this is basically just for reading readiness. He's starting to start, you know, reading some things even without realizing he's reading. He's pointing things out and telling me what show is on television and things like that without realizing he's reading, and he's saying, "Oh, that's on," and he's recognizing it, and it blew me away the first time because I was thinking, how did he know that's what it said? The first time I knew that he was starting to pick up the concept of reading was he was beginning to know who was calling me, even without a picture, based on the name that would come across my phone. So if I had the picture there, which some people I do, but he was even telling me who was calling based on, the words, the letters. So although he's not actually picking up a book reading, that is starting to read. So that blew me away. So it showed me that I needed to nurture his reading readiness and getting him ready for reading because he was ready. I was an early reader, and my son was also a great reader. My daughter is actually a good reader. She just had a little bit more struggles, but she's great now. And actually, when we were doing online school, her teacher's the one who told me that I kept saying she struggles a little. She let me know, no, she's actually above grade level. So where I thought she was not where she should be, it was totally wrong. Which that is why one of my number one homeschooling, I won't say rules, but advice is never, ever judge one child based on another child, because you will find out that if one child's advanced in something, you'll try to compare another child to that, and you'll think that they're not where they should be, when actuality they are advanced, so they may be right where they need to be, and they may even be a little bit ahead of where they need to be. So just try to take each child and nurture where you find them, and don't concentrate on where a person is ahead, where a person is behind. Just nurture their strengths, help them with their challenges, and everything will be okay. Don't stress yourself out and don't worry too much. I know that's easier said than done, but try not to. Okay, now I have been eyeing this book on christianbook.com and on amazon.com, and I kept saying I'm going to get it not only for my pre-K student but also for my soon-to-be sixth grader and third grader, because they have one for, like, I think all the way through middle school. But one of my homeschool mom friends saw it, picked it up for me, and gave it to me for absolutely free. So I did not have to buy. You can see how thick this book is. It has everything in here. I love it. I absolutely love it. I have been doing the little Christian book where you can look through the books, kind of like what Amazon has. But I like Christian book, kind of gives you more pages where you can look at it. But it has everything in here. I love this book. And it's not only great for preschool, the older kids' book seems to be great too. I haven't seen them face to face, but I have looked at them online, and I really like it. It's kind of something good you can do for reviews over the summer, things like that. So I was so blessed that she gave me this book, and I was so grateful. That's why I'm so thankful for friends, real friends. Okay, so we have everything. So that was free. So I really all I spent, let me see how much. I think I spent, I didn't tell you, uh-oh, dropped a book. I didn't tell you how much I spent on this one. Well, this one was $10. So far, I'll just say 19 because it was $8 and something. So far there's what, $23 for all of these. And of course, my big thick kindergarten book was free. And I didn't pull too much from that now, but as the year goes on and I watch where he is and how he's progressing, I will probably pull more from the kindergarten book. If not, I will use it for our actual kindergarten year. But I have a feeling I will be pulling things out of there from time to time as he masters certain preschool skills and moves on and he's ready for the kindergarten skills. I'll pull from that book also. Okay, so we went over our cover. We went over our circle time charts, because this will be something you'll refer to a lot. So I like to keep those in the front. I told you about dividers, and how I divided my binder was by preschool work. I also put in here kindergarten readiness. If I can, this thing is kind of heavy. Let's see. I have my kindergarten readiness tab, and I did these on Word. I did another little insert here for kindergarten readiness here. And I also divided it by artwork. You can see here, I skipped one, I'll go back though. I did artwork, and right here I already have a project that I want to do with him. I put in here, and it's basically we're going to be using household objects to dip in paint and see the different shapes that they do on paper. So I saw that and I already thought, oh, we were going to do that. So I put it in here. Also behind there on the artwork, I have all these empty sheet protectors, and what this is for is all of his artwork that he's going to do for the year. I'm going to keep it in here, the things that I really want to keep and maybe even use for records or things like that, or just to keep for memories. I'm going to keep them in here as I grade them and look at them, and you know, things that he does, just keep them in here in the sheet protectors. I also have grades and reports here where I will be putting in his reports and his grades. I have Christian's completed work here. I have a I already have it set up right here for the beginning of school year. I have a daily assignment sheet here, which is mostly for me to just keep track of what I want him to learn for that week, the concepts I want him to learn, and I'll kind of check it off as he masters them. It may take him longer than a week, but I'm going to keep it there for that reason. In the back of his notebook, I have a map here because I like to start going over continents in pre-K. Start going over it. They may not learn it, but I like to go over it. So this map has the United States, and it has the world map here. I also have beginning writing paper here. So he's going to be learning to write on lines. And I have nursery rhymes here, which will also be for circle time. I have different nursery rhymes to go with different weeks. And as we learn the nursery rhymes and he does his songs for circle time, he'll color a worksheet to go with the nursery rhymes on there. So as the weeks go on, I'll put the nursery rhyme songs, what we're going to do for circle time, and then he'll do his work after circle time. He's also going to be writing his name. He hasn't learned how to write his name yet. He can read his name, he can't write it. So I am going to start. I made this up myself at Kids Zone. So he has his first and last name here. He's going to start off tracing it, and then we'll go letter by letter until he learns it. Now, my poor Christian has the longest name out of all my kids. So we're going to have to do it. He doesn't have a nickname. It would have been good if his nickname was Chris. That would have kind of saved him, which later on that may change. But we call him Christian, so he's going to have to learn to write Christian. But that's okay. I also have stickers here for him. He likes stickers. So as he does his work and he does a good job, he'll get reward stickers. And I kind of let him pull the sticker that he wants. Now, he loves Mickey Mouse too at this point. He's like so into the Mickey Mouse Roadster show. So I still had these from my son who's going to middle school. He had these old stickers he didn't use. So I pulled some Mickey Mouse stickers here. So as he does his work, or even for good behavior, he can get a sticker. I also kept his name here. Why? Because he can look at it every time he opens his binder. We can go over how to spell it. He can start seeing his name regularly, learning the order that the letters come in. So it's kind of on purpose to kind of have him constantly seeing his name. He's learning to write it, he's learning to see it. So we're gonna keep this in his binder. And he also just likes things with his name on it. But this is just a little cardboard. I had a lot of these. It's like a stack of them I found at the Dollar Tree for $1. I've had for years. So I kind of, for each child, I would do the same thing. So I gave them name cards and they kind of read their name. So that's his. Okay, so we went over what is in there. Oh, I skipped one. I forgot. I said I skipped one. I also have theme of the week. Now, I was a preschool teacher for a long time in different schools, well, a couple different schools. And my mother also had a home daycare for over 25 years that I automatically was the teacher since I was like 12 years old. I was in love with finding what they were going to do and how they were going to do it and doing a program myself. So I was kind of like a helper slash getting her kids ready for kindergarten. But this is the preschool theme of the week. So it's kind of like, because I taught preschool for so many years, the themes are just like in my head of what to do and what needs to be covered or what needs to happen. But you can also research preschool themes. I think Google them if you don't know of any, and just choose what you all want to go over. Now my advice is you can go by season. So if you want to do summer, if you want to do spring, so you want to do the seasons, and you can either go over all the seasons at once, or you can stop and say, okay, summer, that's a season, we're going to go over this for the summer. You can do back to school, you know, holidays, numbers, letters, letter of the week, this, whatever. You can do that by the theme. So that's what I will put in that sheet protector, is something that has something to do with our theme for that particular week. So it may be letter of the week is A. He has some cards that have like traceable letters on it. Put that in there. We're going to put some corresponding worksheets to go with that in there so that he can do that. And what I'm going to do is just pull from the binder. If it's like letter of the week A, we got A's in here. We're going to pull from there. We're going to work on those worksheets along with the theme. That is another reason I love the binders, because in a workbook, you're kind of a slave to the page numbers or where the workbook goes, unless you tear them out. With the binders, they're already torn out, as you can see. And a great thing about it is, if you want to go in a certain order and learn something, you can insert it in here with the hole punch. That's what, how I did all of these. And hey, you can insert it. If you decide, oh, you know what, I don't want to teach that way back here, let's move this up. All it takes is unclamping this, moving the work forward. If you decide, I don't think we're going to make that this, you know, talk about that this week, or it doesn't go with what I want to teach this week, you can easily take this out, move it to the back. And that way you're still keeping an order. You don't have to do it that way. You can skip around through the binder, which is another thing I love. I can open up the binder at any page I want and we can work in it. And or if I want to keep an order, depends on how you are. If I want to keep a certain order, I can take out, insert, or whatever. I may be online and I may see something. I'm like, oh wow, this would be a great lesson for him. Guess what? I can print it out, punch a hole, and insert it in my binder for that week or where I want to, you know, start teaching from. So that's why I love the binder concept, because, and not only that, you can take this with you wherever you go. So you have all of your work here. All of your work, you don't have to take books. Everything is here. You can insert maybe a little pen holder here and your school can go with you. I do the same thing for the older kids. They have binders, they have clipboards. So if we decide we want to go somewhere or have a change of scenery, all of our stuff can go with us. So that's why I love the binder concept and why it works. Not only does it work for traveling, it works because I can put things in order as he learns it. I can also reproduce the worksheets and recycle them with the sheet protectors, so we can keep learning the concept before we move forward in the binder. Also, he can look through here and he can see something he wants to learn and he can ask if he can do it. So for some reason, the binder is just a little bit more freeing than the workbook. It's easier for him to turn versus trying to keep, hold the workbook open and it's stuck to the page. The binder is easier for him to turn. Once it's open, he can have the freedom to flip to what he wants to learn. So I love that aspect of it. And I just like the concept that everything is together. I can shelf everything. I don't have to shelf 5 books. I've already taken everything out. I can shelf the books here. Now, in my kindergarten readiness side, I also have a list of what to expect from your kindergartner. Can you see that? This goes over language skills, cognitive development, motor development, social emotional development, developmental skills checklist, which is basic skills, reading readiness, mathematics readiness, writing, and fine small motor skills. So those things, I'm getting off the camera. Those things are things you would want to keep check on throughout the year. Now, don't be concerned if your child's not meeting every single one of these requirements or concepts, because you have time to work on it. It is just kind of something to show you where they should be based on where most kids their age are. But don't be concerned if it's a skill or something they can't pick up or they're not doing. Just keep teaching it and helping them to learn it, and they will be fine. You know, sometimes we stress out about them not being where they are. Try not to. And also, one of my number one advice tips, or I guess tips, look at each one of your children as individuals. Never compare them. Number one, it will lower their self-esteem, because if their sibling is able to do, you know, it's more advanced and can do a lot more, and you're comparing them to them, which is something they may not be capable of doing, it makes them feel like it's something wrong with them, which is not true. We're all different. We all learn differently. So try to look at them where they are and their strengths and their weaknesses, and not compare them to where their sibling was at that time, you know, when they were that age. I have made that mistake. And what I have learned is, even when I thought my child was behind, they weren't. They were ahead. So don't do that. My son was an early reader. He was always great at reading and writing and things like that. And when my daughter struggled a little bit at the beginning, I thought she wasn't reading well. And until she went to the online school, the teacher told me she was actually above grade level in reading. And I never thought that. I always thought she was a little bit behind, only because my son was extremely advanced in reading. She was not behind. She was where she needed to be and above. But I compared her to where he was when he was reading, and you can't do that. And I've learned that with some kids, they're strong here, they may have weaknesses here. Look at them as individuals. You keep a report on each one, and don't worry about anything else. Don't worry about this homeschool family over here and their child is, you know, doing square roots at 7. You know, don't worry about that. Everyone is where they should be and where they need to be based on their strengths and their weaknesses. Don't be concerned, because if you do that, not only are you going to make the kids feel bad, you're going to feel bad, because you're going to feel like you're doing something wrong. And most of the time, that's not the case. Now, if you feel like your child is struggling, they have some difficulties, and it's something they're not getting over, and you're just concerned about it, talk to their pediatrician or professional about it if you really feel like it's something that they're not learning. But like I said before, don't be too concerned about it, because most of the time it's just us being anxious and worrying. And you don't want to do any unnecessary worrying, and you don't want to put unnecessary stress on them. Just take it year by year and take them where they are. And help, if it's something that you maybe they need to repeat the concepts or keep mastering, just keep working on it. And that's my advice about that. Okay, so I'm going to give you a good in-depth look at my binder now that we went over all of that stuff. We went over the books. We went over the inserts. Okay, so now we're entering the pre-K section, or the preschool section. Again, I did this on Word. So in here, I have beginning writing concepts, tracing kind of slanted letters. I also have here still tracing. I'm trying to come as close as I can. We have more just tracing stuff here. So I'm kind of going over the same concept. Then we go in from that to shapes. More on shapes. And then I put a little special science project in here. And I got this from education.com. And this is basically, he's going to cut and paste things that are hot and cold. And I thought that was neat when I saw it. He'll like that because he likes to cut. I also have here from Confessions of a Homeschooler. I love her website. I have the little letters you do with the bingo stamp. So as we start doing letters of the week and we go into letter A, As you can see, I did this on purpose, out of order, with the book. They start on the A, and they'll do activities based on that. And I also added in a worksheet from her website. So you can see I put things in by the topic or the theme, which the binder made it easy to do that. Then we still go back into colors. So not only am I doing his letters, I'm also going back and reviewing some of the other skills along the way. So we're learning new concepts, and we're also still working on our colors and different things that we learned on last year. So that's what I love about this. And you can insert your activities, you can insert your art projects, things that you want to do in your binder. And you know, say you don't cover something in a week, you can move it over, or you can just leave it where it is. Like I say, you don't have to be a slave to the order. Now this I saw and I fell in love with this. Now this is also something I picked up online, and I put it into something we'll probably do for the first day of school. And this is something you do with Fruit Loops. Now what he'll do is he'll divide the colors up, or he'll separate them, and he's going to glue on Fruit Loops for the rainbow. So we'll have the order of the rainbow color, you know, color of the rainbow, and he'll glue the Fruit Loops on. And he'll also be able to keep them in a little cup where as he's doing his project, he can nibble on some Fruit Loops. So I think that's fun to do for the first day of school. And you can do necklaces, you can do after you do that, just eat it. You know, it's just fun to do that type of stuff with kids. And the Fruit Loops are, you know, large size, so it's easy to glue on, and it's colorful, and it's just fun. So that's what I have for preschool. And all throughout the preschool book, I have colors, I have themes. He has new concepts he's learning. For instance, this may be a math lesson where he's learning his coins. He's learning numbers. He's traced some of these already that I saw put back in here. Just to kind of go over again the numbers. And we start from zero, and we work our way up throughout the whole binder. And in between, I insert different things. So he's not just doing the numbers at one time. I have the number zero, and then I have tracing practice for the letters. And then we start on a new letter, which is F. We go back over F, an activity about F. And then the next page may be something about numbers, which it is right here. Find the number 5 and circle it. So as you can see, I kind of mixed it up. Not only is that it keeps you from getting bored, but it makes it easier for me to make sure he's going over more than just one particular subject. He's getting all his things into one, you know, 1 week. So it keeps it exciting, because we don't know when we turn the flap what may be, you know, we may be doing an art project this week. We may be doing a science thing. We may be doing, you know, so every page is different. And I just kind of, the only thing I kept together was if I'm going over concepts, I tried to kind of make it repetitive. So if he's learning the letter A, he's working on something the next day with the letter A, and the next day with the letter A. So if that's our theme, we're keeping with the repetition to get the concept down and mastered. So that's the only thing I did, but the rest of it is very just all over the place. Okay, kindergarten, this is gonna be really quick. The kindergarten readiness, I haven't done too much with the kindergarten. What I did was I started out with the review. Okay, every school year, what did you do? Review, right? You didn't go straight into all the hard concepts. You went over things you learned from the year before, over the summer, things like that. So we go over same shapes, what's the same, what's different. Then we're going to do same amounts. We're going to do one more and one fewer. So these are going to be new concepts, greater than and less than. You know, I think that's something good to do for the beginning of the year. That's something that's not too difficult. Actually, some of these came from the end of the preschool book, because they're starting to go into the beginning kindergarten readiness. I also have here apple picking, just to kind of, he's supposed to tell me back what he, you know, repeat what he sees in the picture. Okay, this is another alphabet chart which we'll be doing as a review. Now, do you see all of these worksheets and sheet protectors? The reason that I did that for some of these was my hole punching skills weren't all that great. So I messed up some of the worksheets, but it was no problem to fit them in because I just slipped them in a sheet protector. So that is how I do my preschool notebook. He also, I don't know if I said this, but he also has a folder in the back for completed assignments. So as we finish something or master a concept, I think I did talk about that because I told you about my little chart that I have. But he can insert his work in there, and for the week we go over it, and then after I grade it, I can file it there, and then we'll move on for the next week, and his work for the next week will go in that folder. Okay, last thing I want to talk about is evaluations for preschool. What I do is I always do a progress report at the beginning of the year. So you can see I'm already getting one ready for him for the year. And this one has three different quarters. It has December, March, and May. What they do is they give you a concept: social, emotional development, work habits, motor skills, language arts and reading readiness, math, science readiness, conduct, and all that stuff. So they give you that, and they give you a grading scale. One, he's a beginning develop. He's beginning it. Two, he's developing that skill. Or three, he's proficient in that skill. So what you would do as the quarters go on is you would grade them based on where they are. Are they beginning? Are they developing? Or are they proficient in it? And you would grade them based on that. Now, I have three of these because I'm going to give him one at three different times of the year. So as I pull from this, I will be able to look at his progress throughout the year. And this also will be what I put in his permanent record. I have a permanent record that I keep for each one of them. And I actually went over and I'm just amazed. I still have my son's kindergarten work and things that he did when he was at in the online school from kindergarten and first grade. And it was so funny to see. I always keep a sample, writing sample, math sample, of them as they progress throughout each school year. And it was so funny to see where he was in kindergarten and his little drawings and writing and things for him and my daughter, and where they are now. So it's fun to go back and look at those samples and say, wow, look how you were writing in kindergarten. And not only that, it kind of makes them feel better because they can see their progress as well. So that's a good thing to keep. But I keep all of those records from beginning pre-K all the way through school. So I'm just getting ready to start a middle school folder, which is amazing. So my son just completed his entire elementary folder, and we're going to be start getting him ready for middle school. And the thing with me this year is I will officially, after sixth grade, I will be starting to start transcripts for him for middle school and high school to get him ready for college. It's amazing and scary. I'm not worried at all, but it's scary because it's just different territory, and that's always a little bit scary. But that's how I do my preschool folders, binders. And I hope you learned something from it. I hope it gave you some ideas. Like I said, whatever I share with you, you never have to go by the book. You never have to do everything that I do. I just give you some helpful hints and things that work. So maybe that will help you think of some things you can do throughout the year. Well, I hope this has helped you. Don't forget to follow me. Just subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet. And I'll try to keep coming up with some things. Now, I am going to do another video soon on the third and the sixth grade materials. If you haven't watched my last video, we will be doing ACE curriculum this year, which is accelerated, I'm tongue-tied, accelerated Christian education. And it is the first time ever that I have purchased a curriculum. I usually do what I did here is buy things and set it up. But because we're going to be in new territory this year, I wanted to have the material so that I can kind of get myself adjusted to the workload and the different things that are going on. So I actually purchased a curriculum, which came up to $578 total for both kids. And my son has six subjects, my daughter has seven. Six for my son, even though he's older, because they incorporate Bible into their social studies. My daughter takes a separate Bible subject. So she has seven, he has six. So I will go over those and more in depth with it. I did show some in another video that you can pull up, but I'm going to go in depth with how I organize their materials. I showed you the preschool organization. We're going to do their organization. They kind of give you some hints of what we're going to do and how we're going to do it. Well, I hope you continue to have a great homeschooling day. And thank you again for watching, and we will see you soon. Bye-bye.